here Mahathir was criticizing Penang State government, saying that it's not right for us to raise water. We should actually conduct awareness campaign to save water. He says that I should not be relying on water tariff hike to save water, but I should conduct campaigns. Actually, we have done that for the last 6 years. We have failed. And yet, he himself admit that they have not succeeded in saving water. People not heeding advice to save water. So this is like slapping your own face, slapping your own mouth. Ini macam pukul mulut sendiri. Satu, belah pihak dia cakap kita harus lancarkan kempen-kempen pendidikan untuk menggalakkan rakyat menjimatkan air. Tapi pada masa yang sama dia pula cakap, oh, rakyat tak mau dengar. So, bukankah ini tanpa mulut sendiri? Itu tak terima. Self-contradictory. You're hitting your own face. These two shows the problems of a failed education campaign. They themselves say that, no, people are not listening to the advice. So what are you going to do if people refuse to save water because water is priced too low? So you have to make it more precious, increase the tariff hike, increase the water tariff so that the public realizes it's very important and they will save water. I'm not actually blaming the people. But this is just a natural question of supply and demand. Everywhere else also the same. When things are cheap, people will tend to waste it. That's laws of supply and demand. So this is natural. So I just want to read this one so I can bring it into penterjemahan kemudian. Let me read this. Number one, the Penang PR state government's proposed water tariff hike is intended to avoid carrying out water rationing, where the proceeds goes towards government's water projects. This is different from sugar price hike that benefits not the government, but only private cronies controlling the sugar business. The pro-BN mainstream media. The pro-BN mainstream media has adopted the MCA and Gerakan line of attack on a proposed water tariff hike by equating the water tariff hike to the sugar price hike. They are saying that, dia cakap, you mana beza dengan Barisan Nasional? Ini ialah daripada mainstream media, termasuk columnist-columnist dalam mainstream media yang menyatakan tak ada beza. BN dan PR tak ada beza. Tapi dia lupa. Kalau dia naikkan harga gula, ia bertujuan untuk membantu kroni-kroni. Kerana kroni-kroni pun sama-sama untung. Kroni-kroni punya untung atas susah rakyat yang terpaksa bayar harga gula yang lebih tinggi. Jadi saya harap mainstream media boleh ambil perhatian. Jangan-jangan hanya menerima bulat-bulat apa yang dikatakan oleh Barisan Nasional, khususnya MCA dan gerakan. Mereka telan bulat-bulat. Kerana yang tentang gula, yang untung ialah kroni-kroni BN. Bukan macam air. Kalau ada apa-apa tambahan, ini pergi kepada kerajaan negeri untuk buat projek air bagi manfaat rakyat. Now, equating the rationale for the water and sugar price hike is illogical and a specious fallacy, because the proposed water tariff hike intends to avoid water rationing in the future. Now, bila kita naikkan harga air, tujuannya ialah untuk kita elakkan daripada jatuhan air. Betul, kita subsidi banyak. Tapi kalau kita tak ada masalah itu jatuhan air, saya rasa kita boleh tahan lagi. Tapi ini kerana kita nak elakkan masalah jatuhan air. The sugar price hike is not to avoid any sugar rationing. So kalau kita cakap ini logik sama, we impose the price hike to avoid water rationing. Are you saying that the federal government of BN impose price hike for sugar to avoid sugar rationing? No. It's to allow the cronies to earn money, to profit at the expense of the hardship of the people. For us, we want to avoid water rationing. Why? Because water rationing, we think, is worse than price hike. If you can get price hike to reduce water consumption and avoid water rationing, it's worth it. Don't forget, you look at the pictures here. These are pictures. This is Taiping, you know. The wettest town in the country, in the peninsula of Malaysia. People are near for water in Taiping. Another photograph. Yeah, it's Taiping. This one is KL. Adian KL. And then this is Taiping. Taiping. And even the Chinese press, Wang Ming, he also got take from the river in Taiping. Take water from the river. I hope not to see that happening in Penang. Unless we want to see this happening in Penang. It's very sad, no? The wettest town in the country taking water from the river. Do you want to see that happening in Penang? No. That's why we have to make hard decisions in order to avoid water rationing. So when the federal government decided not to subsidize sugar by removing the 20 cent subsidy, the private cronies controlling the sugar business did not lose a single cent, but still recorded profits. These profits continue to be earned at the expense of the people who paid a higher price. Syarikat kroni masih untung. Kerajaan negeri masih rugi. Jangan lupa kita bayar 70 juta tiap-tiap tahun untuk bagi subsidi kepada air domestik. Yang air perniagaan tak ada subsidi. So, they are not calculated. Now, saya nak teraskan 3-1-1. You know, the 3-1-1, penggunaan is domestic. No? Yang itu perniagaan tak dikira campur kerana harga air mereka tak disubsidi, harga air mereka ikut komersial dan mereka akan pastikan mereka boleh kurangkan bil. Nah, itu sebab mereka akan jimat air. Any proceeds from the water tariff hike will still belong to the state government and be utilized towards water projects for the people's benefit. PVADP continues to be the best water supply management in Malaysia, with a non-revenue water at 17.6% compared to national average of 36.4%. Now that's why I'm puzzled by what Mahathir said lah, because he himself contradicts. I'm just repeating here. You look at the pictures, you know. Now we have tried to educate the people with templates, education programs. You know, we do our water wash every year. You know. But it didn't work. We even imposed WCS, water conservation surcharge, to punish those who waste water. We penalized them. Didn't work. That's why we feel that if we want to avoid water rationing, in order to reduce water consumption, we have to impose rationing. And then we have to impose a tariff hike. That's why I hope that the press can emphasize this. This is not solely to get more money. This is to avoid water rationing. And any extra proceeds, we still will be subsidizing. But any extra proceeds is, we'll use it to further reduce NRW and do water projects. And you know that the situation is very bad in terms of rain. These 2 months, even though it's rainy weather, expect less rain than last year. And after the next 5 months, drought. This is ASEAN Specialized Meteorological Center in Singapore said low rainfall in April and May and dry and drought in June to October. Now, can we survive June to October? That is my greater concern. Or you end up like this. You want to end up like this or not? Angkat air dari sungai. Saya rasa tak mau. Now, kita nak tegaskan bahawa semua pun kita naikkan kadar tarif air domestik, kita masih paling rendah di Malaysia. Kita subsidi 70 juta tahun lepas untuk memastikan tarif air yang paling rendah. Tarif untuk perniagaan kita tak subsidikan. So ini tak dimasuk kira dalam 311 yang saya sebut tadi. Penggunaan air yang paling tinggi di Malaysia. Ini kita tak masuk kira. Dan saya sekali lagi ingin mengulangi bahawa kerajaan negeri akan carangkan diskaun 60% kepada WCS. Hanya kepada WCS, ha? Bukan untuk semua BIA, ya. Hanya kepada WCS, iaitu mereka yang dihukum kerana guna lebih air. Kita akan bagi 60% diskaun kepada keluarga yang mempunyai 8 dan lebih anggota. Ini untuk membantu keluarga besar. So kalau seperti yang saya sebut semalam, kalau you punya bill ialah RM50, WCS ialah RM10, kita hanya bagi diskaun 60% untuk RM10. Ini sebagai satu contoh saja. Okay.